and we get just get deflated, like in like the wacky waveable inflatable arm man just goes way down. We don't know who we are, what we're doing in life. As far as we're concerned, it's all over because, you know, your friend from high school is now a successful business person. It's not over. They've just, that's another thing. It's like everyone's on a different journey that, and you are as well, also. And sometimes we might not get it right, but that's how we learn. But we shouldn't judge others for what they're going through, and nobody should judge you really, even though we do, which is annoying. But you know, you're here to do what you have to do, and what someone else is doing is actually nothing to do with you. It's nothing, none of your business, okay? Hey guys, welcome to the Crystal Line Podcast, a podcast all about self-worth and achievement. I'm your host, Sam Clark, and today we're going to talk about how can I help someone who has given up on themselves? Well, that's really hard. It's like, you don't. Well, it's a really tricky question because everyone is different. Everyone's going through their own little thing that they're going through. The best thing you can do is nothing. No, the best thing you can do is the best you can. You'll find that actually people don't, even though you can care a lot for this person, you'll actually find that it's hard to help them because a lot of people don't want help. A lot of people, you know, they just don't want it. It's really hard. They have to get to that place of acceptance. It's like, okay, now I need help. I'm forever telling people is that you can't help people, you can only guide them, because if you're forcing someone to do something that they don't want to do, that's not right for them. That's not in line with who they are. That's just you telling someone what to do because you think that's best. Just because you think it's best, it doesn't actually necessarily mean it is actually best for them. But you know, it's up to them. The best thing you can do for them is talk to them and say, you know, and this, if this is for you as well, like if you've lost motivation, you've lost the will to live, basically. And it sucks when you're in that place because it's horrible because you feel like there's no way out, there's nothing you can do, there's just nothing for you on this planet. Maybe one day, you know, when like, I think, was it SpaceX when that like happens and we can go to another planet? But like, you know, for now, it's best, like, a self-acceptance is a great thing, you know, to accept where you are in life because you're not going to stay there forever. And one of my favorite quotes actually is something, no, it's this too shall pass. So whatever you're feeling now is so sad, but it's like that happy moment, that thing that you're feeling where everything is good in life, that's gonna pass. But it sounds really bad, but you know, on the other hand, when you're going through bad times in life, this too shall pass, you know, this too shall pass. It's just up to you to, you know, find the solution to the problem. How can you go from what A to B? What is, you know, why? Identify first, why are you feeling like this? Why do you feel like you want to give up on yourself? Why are you feeling that? You can always do the seven whys, which is a really was a really it's a dark place. No, it's not. It's a really like, oh crap, because sometimes we don't actually understand how we're feeling, and we don't, you know, understand, you know, why, how, who, when, you know. It's like, it's crazy that it's just crazy. But if you do the seven whys, like, so like ask yourself a question. It's like, why am I feeling like this? because la-di-da. And you'll be like, but why is the la-di-da? And then you'll constantly ask yourself until you get to the seventh answer. Or sometimes you might need some more. That can really help. I mean, I've done this on myself, and it didn't work for me at that time. This might work for you, but at that time it didn't work for me. And actually, it was my instincts telling me that this thing was wrong at that time. It's like, this thing is wrong. I was like, but why? Why does it feel wrong? It's just wrong. So sometimes it's really great to listen to like your own intuition, your own instincts on with the problem. It's like, why is this not working? Oh my God. How can I, how can I take the next step? Why am I feeling like this? What can I do to get out of it? And sometimes people don't want to get out of it. Like, I can tell you this morning, I was not in the mood for this podcast. Honestly, no, because I set myself up to, probably record like the podcast with video, but I was like, sometimes I just cannot be bothered to look nice for the camera. And I was like, I just don't want to do it this way. And I found a way out of it, which is basically just to have audio. Sometimes I might feel good enough for the camera, but it's the whole problem with I'm exhausted for like editing. It's like I cannot bother to edit the video because it actually takes a long time. That's why I removed like video from this podcast because it just took too long. Okay, and I didn't have time. It was so sad, but with audio it's like less of like, I don't know, a megabyte, I don't know what the fuck they're called. And it worked. Like it worked so much better. So that's what I found for me. It sounds so stupid. It's just like a real fucking problem that you've got. And I'm just like, yeah, I just can't be bothered to fucking edit. That's my problem. But it actually was incredibly stressful because I was putting so much pressure on myself. And this is what we do, actually. We do put a lot of pressure on ourselves and we do overthink things and we overthink our lives. And a good person to look up is like Eckhart Tolle. He's really good for, staying mindful with things, finding your center, finding, not yourself, but being mindful. But he doesn't like the word mindful. He likes like being conscious of, where you are and what you're doing and what you're thinking, because we can get so caught up in everything, and I do it, and I recently did it, but it's okay because we're all human and we have to forgive ourselves for what we've done, and not that necessarily we've done something bad, like it's, run over a cat. It's like I have to forgive my. It's like that's not very nice. Cats are great, but dogs are better. But it's okay. We can forgive ourselves. We're human, and we forget this. We forget that we're human, it's like we've all got this mindset that we have to be perfect, we have to be good enough, we have to be this or that, but it's like, well, actually, we all fart, we're all human, come on, we've all got, that in common at least. It's natural to make mistakes, it's natural to feel sad sometimes, it's natural to, I mean, we do get depressed and we do get so not motivated. And like I said before, I set this up, I was like, okay, I just cannot be bothered to do this. Or like, it was just like, I just don't want to do it because, it's a lot for me, but I still do it because people are listening and I don't want to give up on them. And sometimes, sometimes I haven't posted an episode just because I've been tired, and that's okay. And I'm sorry, you guys. Forgive me for doing that, but I'm human and I need it, just like you guys. Okay, so don't ever worry about like these things that that make you feel like you're not good enough. It's just like, why do you not feel motivated? And a lot of people don't. It could be something to do with their diet. It could be just the lifestyle in general. Just going to work, working in a job that just brings them no fulfillment. And you can change that because that's what I'm doing right now. I'm working a job that doesn't give me like fulfillment. It doesn't give me the best, like, I can tell you this, I actually gave a death stare to a customer the other day. It was just like she took it really well. She just asked me to clean a table, and I had had enough at that point, and I looked at her, and I looked at her. I think I gave her the most scariest look because she was like, "Ooh!" Well, she like kind of made a horse noise and like laughed. She's like, "Ooh, what is this?" But she took it really well. But I looked at her, and I just walked away. It's like, for fuck's sake, I cannot stand people anymore. I just don't want to do what they tell me to do. It's so fuck off. I'm so done. And but she took a while. She's like, "Are they working you hard here?" I was like, "Yeah, I'm just so fucking done." Just... But the thing is that I don't have to be there, okay? I can change that, and I can, find a better job that's more professional. I said to my friend, I was like, I just want a job where I can have my hair down, I can do my nails nice, I can wear heels, and I want to wear a suit. And yeah, there was like a lot, there was a lot going on. if anyone's seen like Parks and Recreation, where Ron laughs, oh, it's so funny. Because I said to my sister, I was like, "I'm gonna quit my job," and she was like, "Why?" And I sent her a gif of Ron laughing, and I was just like, "That's hands down, like, it's the most ridiculous like question I've ever heard." It's like, why? It's like, just made me laugh. But that's the thing. It's like, well, actually, I can change that, and I can have something more professional, and that's exactly what you can do. And I'm telling you right now that I believe that you can do it, right? I really truly believe that it's possible because, I mean, I'm doing it. There are a lot of people out there that have done it. Why can't you? Is it because, you've developed this thought pattern that limits you just because it's not your fault, it's what you've been brought up with, it's what you've learned, it's who you've s what you've seen and what you've taken on from other people. It's actually, if you realize it, if people realized how much control they had over their lives, some things, yeah, some things you can't control, but some things have to happen to you in order to, for personal growth. It doesn't necessarily mean, it's not the end of the world. It's something, just do what you can control. I actually, and I had to comment on a video recently because I was like, right, I just have to leave my job. This is what I have to do. And there was a video. There's so many things confirming it because I'm totally one of those there's people that believe, like, if there's a sign from the universe, which you guys should look out for, if there's like a sign from the universe, it's obviously you going in the right direction. So I think I was like, yeah, I'm just gonna quit my job. And there was this person that just absolutely woke me up instantly because there's like, we've all got our talents and we've all got things that we can do. And there was this person who's out there doing it, who was living proof of something that I wanted to do. And I was watching a video, and then he just turns up with like gin. And he turns up with like gin and like glasses. And I was like, it was just so funny the way I just saw him instantly. And they were like, the things, basically it's like tailoring he does, but I want to do someone else. But I love the way he had like little pattern samples on the table and buttons, And I was like, that's what I should be doing. It's like, what am I like? It just really uplifted me. And I was like, damn. And if you got something like that in your life, it's like, this is a message. That's such a message for you. And I was like, okay, the time is now, sort of. I'm getting there. And then someone else posted a video at the same time saying, like, do what you can. What can you control? And I also love the Teddy Roosevelt, which got me way out of stress for a long time. It's like, do what you can with what you have where you are. And that really de-stressed me at one time in my life. It's, yeah, that was bad. But just do what you can. Do what you can control and don't worry about what you can't. Okay? So do what you can control. Don't worry about what you can't, because that's probably a personal growth thing. It's so stressful what you can't control. But there is a lot of solutions to a lot of problems. You wouldn't believe it. There is so much amazing, like, because we're in a time now that there have been so many like entrepreneurs out there that have solved a problem for you, they've done it. And I was like, I was just watching, like, I was just on Pinterest this morning, and it was like stupid things. I was watching like a van life kind of video, and someone had invented a thing to put in the water to whirl it around, and I was like, well, that's basically a washing machine. And I was like, that's a fucking genius. And then I got like down a rabbit hole of watching loads of like van life videos. But there's so many things that they've invented that are so handy, because I don't know if you've ever been on a holiday, like you've lived in a van, yes, for 5 weeks on holiday. It can get really stressful because you have to clean up after yourself, you have to find place things, you have to be like really organized. And I was just like, wow, there's like solutions for it's like a long-winded point, but there are solutions out there. And if there isn't a solution, that's called a gap in the market, and then you go get that patent and you invent it and then you make millions. It's fine. But there's always a way out. There's always something you can do. And I love, and I've said it so many times, that Stephen Hawking quote of like, I really should memorize this off by heart, but he basically said there's always something you can do. I don't know the rest of it, but it's right, there's always something you can do that you can be good at, no matter what. There's something out there for you that you need to do. People just don't know it yet, because, yeah, like I said, they get caught up in their jobs, they're in a job that they hate. But you can change that. You can do what you want to do. They're eating food that is not serving them. They have people in their life that don't serve them. They watch TV that don't serve them. Like, our brains are like sponges, so they do. Like, it's funny. It's like funny you think that, but like, they everything you like. All your senses, everything, like if they absorb into your brain, like my sister's studying to be a forensic psychologist, so we end up watching like these videos, no, like these documentaries of like murder mysteries or like unsolved murders and stuff. And then for some reason in my brain, it would just be like, my sister would be like, oh, I'm just gonna pop to the shop, and then in my brain it would be like, do do do. And that's the last time. And that's the last time Lois was seen. Sorry, that's my sister's name. And oh dear. It's like, and it's horrible because it does happen. It has happened to people, but that's just what runs through my head. So I've stopped watching those kind of shows. And if you've fallen down that rabbit hole of like watching those horrible, weird TikToks where it's like ding ding, like the stupid music, and yeah, that's just not good for you, because you're putting things like that into your brain. We're so easily influenced, our brains. Like, I just can't. A lot of us are sheep, and that really annoys me because we're so individual And sometimes all it takes is is it a pep rally? I don't know what they're called, where someone stands on a box and they're like yelling stuff, and then everyone's like, yeah. And it's like, is that all it takes? It's like, well, actually, we're all really different. I know there's a lot of niches and categories that people fit into what they believe, but it really is up to you what you choose to believe and what you choose to do. Don't murder anyone. That would suck. Don't do that. But it really is up to you. And we all have a brain, and with our brain we all have our own opinion. Our it's like that's like, oh, duh. We really have our own say. And sometimes people won't agree. And my mum always said, what is it? If everyone liked the same bread, the world would be a boring place. There's a lot of variety. Variety? 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 A variety out there for us. And we can, we can do whatever we like with that, because that's what makes the world a beautiful place. The way we're all different, the way we have our ideas, and it's like, oh wow, and how we can be inspired by other people for what they do, because they're doing it, and it's like you've got to find out what's right for you, what motivates you, and sometimes we don't know, and that's okay, because you can go out there and find it. That's why the world isn't, your four walls. It's like it's a whole freaking world out there. It's a whole freaking place that you can see, and you can get inspired by things. And sometimes we just don't find that yet, because we're in like a lifestyle that's not right for us, and we get just get deflated, like in like the wacky waveable inflatable arm man just goes way down. We don't know who we are, what we're doing in life. As far as we're concerned, it's all over, because your friend from high school is now a successful business person. It's not over. They've just, that's another thing. It's like everyone's on a different journey, that, and you are as well, also. And sometimes we might not get it right, but that's how we learn. But we shouldn't judge others for what they're going through, and nobody should judge you, really, even though we do, which is annoying. But you're here to do what you have to do, and what someone else is doing is actually nothing to do with you. It's nothing, none of your business, okay? Vice versa, what you need to do is absolutely your thing, okay? And I have to take this for I have to take this advice on myself, because I want to change jobs, and there's something I can do, which I said when this guy came on screen, the gin guy, and he was like, this is how I live my life. And I was like, that's what I want to do, and it's something that I can do. But it's funny is that I'm scared to do that, because I come from a family that, they're all professional people, and they're all making like thousands, fucking, I don't know. And it's like, I would be scared. There's something in my brain telling me I'm terrified, because I'm scared that they'll judge me for not having a professional career. And that's the story that I'm telling myself. It might not necessarily be true, but it's something I can do, and I can make money from it, quite a bit of money. So why should anybody else, have an opinion on what you want to do? As long as you're happy and doing what you want to do, why should anyone else have a say in it? It's none of their business. It's none of their business. Just do what makes you happy, honestly, honestly. But if you can't find it, like you said, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Even if you judge yourself for your age, there's as well, like, there's a lot of people. One of my friends in his 70s before he figured out how, what made him happy and what he wanted to do. That's fine. That's fine. I recently learned that there was a CEO. What was it? Yeah, there was a CEO that quit his job recently just because he wanted to, like, of a multi-millionaire company, just because he could. He quit his job so he could spend more time on the beach. Okay? So you have to do what makes you happy. It's nothing to do with, what other people think. Nothing, all right? So take a look at your diet, take a look at your lifestyle. What is it? What is it that you're doing? What's not serving you? Get rid of everything that's not serving you. Start doing self-love things. Sorry. Start doing things, a self-care routine, even if it's 5 minutes a day, just to help yourself realize, what it is. Because if you start doing these little things, it will build up, and then you recognize your self-worth. And then that can lead to multiple paths, because then if you recognize your own value, then you'll recognize, that there is a change that needs to happen in your life, that you deserve better, and that you can do better, and you don't have to live the life that you're living right now. Okay, so go treat yourself. Okay? Take care of yourself. There's nothing wrong with it. You can do this. I believe in you. Try your best. And I think I'll see you in the next episode, you guys. It'll be next week. And thank you so much for listening. This has been the Crystal Line Podcast, and I've been Summer Clark talking shit. Okay, thank you so much, you guys. If you want coaching, it's there. Amphi, sign up. And I'll talk to you about anything that you want. Bye.